Okay, today we're going to look at CSS Grid and how you can use it to overlap one item on top of another. Something that you would normally use position absolute for would be one approach, but CSS Grid gives us this ability. So let's jump in and have a look at how we might go about that. So I'll just create HTML page here and put some boilerplate code in. Alright, so we're going to need two items, so I'm just going to create a couple of divs. And that should do that for me. We would want to go two divs with a class of item dollar. There you go, that's better. So we have one item one, and another one called item two. And what we'll do is I'll style them to be a couple of spheres so that we can get one bigger, one smaller, so we can overlay them and you'll be able to see that. So let's create style. Let's go do it. Style, yep. And we have dot items one. Interesting. Background color orange. Okay, orange for that, and border radius 50%. That should give us a nice sphere. I'm going to create another one for items. We're just going to try and get a bit more room here. Get rid of that. And that's fine. Just make this a bit smaller. Okay. See a little bit there, hopefully. Right, so we should have two items now. And if we just have a look at what they look like. This starts up, it should appear in here. Okay, probably want to give them a width to make them a little bit more nice. Width. So item one will use as the background, so let's make that 200, so it's quite a bit bigger. So, and then the one that we're going to overlay, we'll just make half the size. Like so. Right, so we now look at that. That looks a little bit better. I need a different colour so we can see this. A lovely blue there. Right, now, so what we want to do is overlay item 2 on item 1. Items is annoying me too much. Let's ensure it's called item 1, item 2. Right, so what we need to do is add these into a container that we've applied grid to. So if I create a div here, to div container, like that, here and say display grid. Now to set up the grid, we need to specify what columns, what rows, and where the elements sit in there. So to get this overlay going, what we're going to do is create a grid with just one column, one row, so it's basically just a box, and we'll say item one goes in position one and item two goes in position one. So to do that, do grid template columns, and we just say one FR, so FR is a fraction, because there's only one column, it will just fill the entire width there. And grid template rows, again we just give it one FR, and then we can set up the area. Grid template area, and we give that a name, and we'll call it the overlap area. That's your area, it's grid template areas. Right, so that shouldn't make any difference at all at the moment. If I refresh it, they're still there. But if I now say on here, this one is to be placed in grid area overlap, and this one is also grid area overlap, and we have a look at that, we'll find now is they're both positioned in that column row for the grid. So item two is sitting on top of item one. Now we can move this around a little bit. I think do a line self center, and also justify self center. Hopefully this puts it in the middle, it should look a bit nicer for us. Not totally in the middle. Let's just put a border on here, see where the main grid is. Like that. Yeah, so I mean it is in the centre. Yeah, this one is in the centre, just item one. We would just want to do the same on item one, and that should give us a nice feel of the overlay there. So that is how you can overlap items using CSS grid. This technique of using grid template areas is the kind of easiest way I think there is to understand what's going on. You can specify named rows and columns. There's lots of ways to configure it, but this is the way I feel is the easiest to understand. So there you go.